Namaste and welcome to the weekly weather discussion presented by India Meteorological Department. We shall discuss the weather and rainfall scenario during the past week and outlook for the coming 2 weeks, which comprise of the last fortnight of the calendar period of Southwest Monsoon. What we are viewing here is the weather systems which occurred during the past week. Weather-wise, it had been quite active with the formation of the first monsoon depression during the season. It formed over Northwest Bay of Bengal, became a deep depression, crossed North Odisha coast close to south of Chandbali on 13th morning, early morning of 13th, and moved across Odisha, North Chathisgarh during 12th to 14th September, weakened into a Velmakulopushi area over Northeast Madhya Pradesh on 15th. At the same time, last week's Lopushi area, which lay over East Rajasthan, it persisted over the same region and gradually shifted to the south towards Gujarat region, southern parts of Gujarat region during 10th to 13th. It became less marked on 14th, but the associated cyclonic circulation remained over the same region and provided a rainfall, good amount of rainfall over the rain-deprived state of Gujarat. Then, in the presence of these two active systems, monsoon trough remained much to the south of its normal position and deeply coupled in the vertical. It remained active with two embedded low-pressure systems. There was an east-west trough also extending up to metropospheric levels across, passing across central India, providing uniform and well-distributed rainfall over central parts and northwest India. Then there was a favorable western disturbance also moving across northern parts of the country during 12th to 14th September. When we are looking at the evolution of clouds, we can see here in association in the initial formation of the low pressure area over North Bay of Bengal and how the clouds getting reorganized in the presence of the deepening of the system, low pressure system over the Bay of Bengal, its movement further and causing a lot of rainfall like this. Whatever is shown here is the rainfall during the week, and on this particular day of depression just about to cross Odisha coast, Odisha received some exceptionally heavy rainfall, and in association with the low pressure system, Gujarat, the western part of Gujarat, that is Saurashtra, received some exceptionally heavy rainfall. These were the major pattern during the week. And how we are now on day-to-day basis, how the rainfall had been, the plotted here on India map are these various dots you can see, which is seen to be of green light rainfall. Cyan color is shown to be as moderate rainfall, and heavy rainfall dots are there for this denoted by this yellow color, and some of this orange, saffron color and red colors are also seen here, which are of very heavy and extremely heavy rainfall amounts. And in association with the depression, we may notice that this rainfall which occurred over in association with the formation initially, the rainfall picked up all along the central parts of the country and also along the west coast initially, but later on the rainfall got concentrated mainly over central India, that is Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Gujarat mainly, and northern parts of Maharashtra also received a few days rainfall. And the amount plotted here in red, it shows that the highest rainfall reported on that particular day. So initial 3 days had been somewhat in the near normal type of activity, and rainfall had not been much, of only of the order of 12 to 15 centimeter getting reported over Rajasthan, western parts of Madhya Pradesh, then Haryana, Rohtak one station reported 15 centimeter on 12th. Further, with the low depression and deep depression crossing the coast, Odisha started getting extremely heavy rainfall for a certain area. But on this particular day of 13th, Odisha reported an exceptionally heavy rainfall of 53 centimeter. It caused some flash floods as well as riverine floods also were reported in Mahanadi. Floods are getting reported over some parts of Odisha. So this was the amount, very high amount of rainfall had been there on 13th and 14th over Odisha, followed by the systematic movement of the rain belt into Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh. And but on 14th, whatever we are seeing here, Lodhika one station in Saurashtra, close to Rajkot, it is reporting 52 centimeter. This also had to have some relation with the association with the deep depression movement as well as the low pressure system which prevailed over this region. So altogether, the zone was quite active, and further, even after the westward movement of the system, Gangetic West Bengal reported an extremely heavy rainfall day. That is, Midnapur and Kharagpur reported 28 centimeter on 15th, when the system weakened over northeast Madhya Pradesh into a well-marked low pressure area, mainly due to the large-scale low-level convergence and moisture incursion from the Bay of Bengal. So this had been the situation. And here what we are seeing is the monsoon activity. When we will call the monsoon to be active or vigorous, when we will call it as active, when the rainfall amount happening is more than 1.5 times of the long period average for a particular subdivision. That rainfall is calculated in the area weighted rainfall. So the red colors are showing the weak activity, weak monsoon activity, whereas cyan and deep blue colors are showing active and vigorous respectively. So here we can see that active and vigorous monsoon belt had been mainly confined to central India and northwest India on most of the days during the week. And whereas we are getting the subdued activity, that is weak monsoon activity, over northeastern states, all the seven states comprising Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Tripura experienced weak monsoon conditions all through the week. And so the resultant cumulative rainfall for the week, percentage departures are shown here, meteorological subdivision wise percentage departures are shown here. Here also the dark blue colors are representing the large excess rainfall compared to the long period average, and light blue are just excess rainfall, and red color shows deficiency, rainfall, deficient rainfall, and green normal, and yellow color is shown by the large deficient rainfall. So these are the same pattern, whatever on station wise rainfall we have seen, the same pattern is reflected in the percentage departure as well. And so the week had been quite exceptionally good in terms of rainfall, where rain deficient states so far like Odisha and also Gujarat received a large excess rainfall. Here the figures are shown here. Country as a whole for the week had been plus 53 when compared to its long period average. And the season as a whole, now at present it is remaining to be minus 4%, even till 16th. Now the figure shown is up to 15th September, and adding the 16th, today's rainfall also, the rainfall percentage departure remains to be minus 4%. Mainly we are getting near normal for the broad geographical regions comprising East and Northeast India and Northwest India are coming in the below normal rainfall category, but it is in the within plus or minus 20 we are considering for the broad region as normal only. So all these rainfall amounts are in the normal category, where South Peninsula for the country as a whole coming under the excess category plus 12%. And this is the day-to-day activity day by day till 15th September is shown here in the above map, where we can see that in the initial part of June we had above normal, then followed by a below normal spell towards the end of June and beginning of July. Almost most of the days of July remained below normal, but only the last week of July the rainfall activity picked up, and the trend followed towards the beginning of August, but still August in the first half remained more or less below normal, followed by much above normal September. And in this table, what we can notice is that for September 1st to 16th September, the rainfall for the country as a whole realized is plus 32.8%, the Central India is the major contributor. Central India received plus 84% of rainfall, its long period average, followed by South Peninsula plus 39%, and then the worst geographical zone is Eastern Northeast India, which received a deficiency of minus 31 so far. And week by week performance is shown here. We can see here the week how it fared. In the last 2 weeks of the initial part of July, there had been this highest rainfall deficiency. Then the current week, which is plus 53, stands to be the best week during the season, with highest percentage departure of rainfall. And here we are seeing the today's weather features. What we have as a synoptic scale system today is the remnant of the deep depression lying over northern parts of Madhya Pradesh as a well-marked low pressure area. Its cyclonic circulation is extending, it is quite deep even now, but there is no tilt in this circulation. It is seen over the same region even up to 5.8 kilometer roughly. Then again, currently also the monsoon trough is remaining to the south of its normal position, and it has a vertical extension, and there is a trough extending from northern parts of northwest Arabian Sea towards the cyclonic circulation across Gujarat and Rajasthan. There is another fresh development seen over the Bay of Bengal today is that a cyclonic circulation has developed over East Central Bay of Bengal and adjoining Myanmar coast. It extends up to mid-tropospheric levels. It has a predominant southwestward tilt with height as well. And how we are expecting the systems to evolve during the coming week is shown here. Unfortunately, the animation is not working here in this platform. The well-marked low pressure area, which is lying over central parts of North Madhya Pradesh and neighborhood, is likely to weaken gradually during the next 2 days. However, if it is weakening and becoming less marked, also the cyclonic circulation is likely to persist for subsequent 2 to 3 days. And the cyclonic circulation, which has formed over East Central Bay of Bengal and adjoining Myanmar coast, it is likely to move towards Odisha West Bengal coast around 18th September, and subsequently it is expected to move across Odisha, Jharkhand, North Chhattisgarh and North Madhya Pradesh. Then it is likely to become also slightly a bit more marked during the subsequent 2 to 3 days. At the same time, about monsoon trough, we may expect it to remain to the south of its normal position or near normal position during the ensuing week. So, based on today's assessment, these warnings given are shown in this graphics. We expect that under the influence of this well-marked low pressure area and associated cyclonic circulation and also the active monsoon trough, we are expecting some extremely heavy rainfall amounts, more than 20 centimeter during 24 hours time, to happen over Uttar Pradesh today. And then tomorrow also it might be slight very heavy amounts of rainfall could continue in the presence of the low pressure area, but with the weakening and its slight shifting in a southwestward manner, the rainfall amount could reduce over these areas. We are expecting isolated heavy to very heavy rainfall in association with this low pressure area. Easterlies are impinging on the hills. So Uttarakhand also to experience some heavy to very heavy rainfall as on today. And there can be some isolated heavy falls during the period of 19 to 22nd September over Uttarakhand. Their isolated heavy rainfall is also likely over Haryana and Chandigarh today. Then we are expecting it to reduce from tomorrow. There is a likelihood that East Rajasthan and Gujarat region might be experiencing some heavy rainfall on 16th and 17th. And there can be an increase further with very heavy falls on during 18th to 22nd over this region. At the same time, West Rajasthan and Saurashtra also some heavy rainfall likelihood is there for during 18th to 20th September. Odisha and Gangetic West Bengal eastern sector, which also received some deficiency, experienced some deficiency in rainfall so far during the season, but got some good rainfall during the current spell, once again is likely to experience some isolated increase in rainfall activity with isolated heavy falls from 18th to 20th September, and then subsequently over Chhattisgarh. This might be spreading over to Chhattisgarh with a likely movement of the cyclonic circulation across these regions. So that is our expectation, and so overall outlook for the week one for the period 17 to 23rd September could be an increased rainfall, above normal rainfall activity over northwest and also central India, and near normal over northeast India, and below normal activity over south peninsular India comprising the Kerala, then parts of southern Maharashtra, then Telangana, Andhra Pradesh, southern parts of Chhattisgarh. These areas might be experiencing below normal rainfall activity during the period. And coming to the next week's expectations, that is ensuing week for 24th to 30th September, last week of September, monsoon trough there, then also we are expecting the monsoon trough to continue to remain active. At present, there could be some regular formation of cyclonic circulations and cyclonic vortices on this trough zone, which is extending even up to West Pacific. So in that trough, the fresh cyclonic circulation is likely to develop over eastern Bay of Bengal off Myanmar coast during the beginning of the second week. It is also very likely to move west-northwestwards and cause a fresh spell of rainfall activity over east and central India commencing from 25th September for the subsequent 4 to 5 days. So we are expecting an active situation in the coming 2 weeks, remaining 2 weeks of September as well. So that is shown here in the as a direct model output of our extended range forecasting system. It is shown here for the week 2, above normal activity likely over northwest and central India, and then below normal over east and northeast India. That is the expectation for the this week. So that's all for the this week's summary and outlook for the next 2 weeks. Thank you.